Currently, I am in my second year as a PhD student in the same division where I completed my master's degree, of course at Linköping University. And yeah, although I chose to continue my studies in this academic field, but most of my fellow graduates got their industry jobs right after finishing the program, either in Sweden or other countries across Europe. So I would say there's a high demand out there for engineers in this field, which means the students in the program have their very bright future. The program offers two specializations. The first one is my specialization, analog IC design, and the second one is system on chip or digital IC design, in other words. And students can choose between these two in the second semester of their studies, so they can be sure that they have courses, tools, and resources well prepared for their studies in the domain that they are interested in, both analog and digital. For those coming from warmer climates, especially for where it's hot all year, like my home country, it is a good idea to prepare for Swedish winter. You know, with some nice winter clothing, you will not only stay comfortable, but also will learn to enjoy the beauty of winter here. And for the program, since it is master level, so we do not cover basic electronics, but we dive into more advanced and specialized areas to support your interests and future career in electronics. So it is helpful to refresh the knowledge from your bachelor's degree before coming here so that you can focus on learning new concepts and gaining new experience when you are studying here. My time at this university was incredibly fulfilling. I gained the in-depth knowledge that I was looking for, and everything I learned from my master education has been directly applicable to my work nowadays as a researcher in IC design. So I would say the program equipped students with both practical skill sets as well as theoretical understanding necessary to succeed in the electronics industry. And yeah, for me, everything from my master education is useful and relevant to what I do today. The transition into my PhD life was very straightforward. When I was finishing my master thesis, a PhD position in my division that is responsible for the program became available. So without hesitation, I applied for it. And since at the time I had already spent almost 2 years in Linköping, so I was familiar with everything here, the system, the environment, or even the people around here. And that made the transition into my working life very smooth. Yeah, so as a PhD student, my primary focus is my research, obviously. However, I am also involved in teaching as a teaching assistant, lab assistant, or even a supervisor in some project-based courses in the program. So my working routine changes depending on the time of year. For example, as now we approach to the examination period, so I don't have much teaching at the time, and I'm mostly focused on my research, preparing for the upcoming semester teaching duties, as well as attending meetings internally and externally, since we collaborate closely to many companies and organizations.